it is Memorial Day, and with the start of summer upon us, it is a great time to talk about sun protection. Joining us this morning with tips on how to choose the best sunscreen for your skin is cosmetic dermatologist Dr. Jessica Wu. Doctor, it's good to see you. Good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Of course. So let's start with the basics when it comes to sunscreens. There's so many options out there. What should we be looking for in a sunscreen?
Well, it can be really overwhelming with so many choices. So I'm going to make it a little easier for you. Two things to look for when choosing any sunscreen. Number one is look for a sunscreen with SPF 30 to 50 because that'll protect you against the UVB burning rays. And also look for the words broad spectrum, which means it'll protect you against the UVA aging and skin cancer rays. And the rest depends on your skin type.
And I just realized, Dr. Wu, I use your sunscreen every morning. Every morning. You've got specific tips when it comes to your skin and the type of skin you have. So let's say you have oily or acne-prone skin. What's the best sunscreen?
So if you've got oily or acne-prone skin, you want to use a lightweight sunscreen that's not going to break you out. I like this one by Cetaphil. It's new for the summer. It's their oil-absorbing moisturizing sunscreen, SPF 30. It's great because it reduces shine and it won't break you out. Now, with any sunscreen, even if you have oily skin, don't skimp because it's tempting to use a little bit, but then you won't be protected. One mistake I see a lot of people doing is they'll rub it in really well, or they'll rub it between their hands and then put it on their face, but then you end up protecting your palms and not your hands as much. So don't skimp. By a thin layer, like you're frosting a cake.
Okay, good to know. And then if you have dry skin, what do you recommend?
If you've got dry skin, look for a richer moisturizing sunscreen cream like this one by Kula. It contains hyaluronic acid, which has a skin hydrating benefit. It's organic, it's SPF 50, and it's not going to leave you greasy. So it will also protect you against blue light from your devices. Now, with any sunscreen that you're using, remember to reapply every 2 to 3 hours so you're protected throughout the day.
And then what sunscreen do you recommend for people with darker complexions? Because the complaint is that you see that kind of white cast over your skin, right?
Yes, yes. Nobody wants to look pasty, especially if you have a more richly pigmented complexion. So many of my patients ask me what to look for when they don't want to see sunscreen on their skin. Look for the words clear or invisible or sheer. I love this one by Supergoop. It's their unseen sunscreen, and it truly is invisible. It dries invisibly, and it's weightless. It's wonderful.
And a great sunscreen you'd recommend when it comes to the whole body. And is it true that when you see there's a sunscreen just for the face, that that really should be used for the face and vice versa?
You can use any sunscreen for the face on the rest of your body, and any one that's meant for the body on the rest of on your face as well. But one that I really like for the body is this one. It's the Bare Republic Clear Screen Spray SPF 50. It goes on clear, it dries fast, and it's water resistant. So if you're headed to the beach or pool today, look for the words water resistant and make sure you reapply after you get out of the water. Now, most important thing when using a spray, do not spray it directly on your face because you don't want to get any sunscreen in your eyes or up your nose. You certainly don't want to inhale the fumes, especially if you're spraying your kids. So spray it on your hands first and then apply it to your face.
Okay, speaking of kids, you see every parent trying to put sunscreen on their kid and they're just chasing them, you know, around the room. What's a good one for children?
Yeah, so I really like sunscreen sticks for children, like this one's brand new this summer. It's by Neutrogena. It's their Sheer Zinc Kids Mineral Sunscreen Stick, SPF 50. It really does go on sheer, and it comes in this large stick, like it's like the size of a deodorant, so you can cover them really quickly. And it's great for kids because it doesn't budge. It won't melt into their eyes and sting. Adults can use it too, by the way.
Yeah, and then quickly, if we do get a little too much sun, what's the best way to kind of revive our skin?
Well, remember that a sunburn is a real burn, so you've got to treat it seriously. Get out of the sun ASAP, cover up with a towel or a shirt. You've got to get that skin temperature down. So wring out a cold washcloth, apply it on the burned areas, or use aloe to cool down. Take an aspirin or ibuprofen to reduce the inflammation. And lastly, drink a nice tall glass of iced green tea, because some studies show that green tea can reduce the DNA damage even after you've gotten burned.
Good to know.
So stay safe out there.
Yeah, doctor. Thanks for the tips. Appreciate it. Good to see you. For more on Dr. Jessica Wu, you can go to drjessicawu.com or follow her on Instagram. We'll be right back.